بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. Brothers and sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Learn Arabic grammar the easy way. We will take فاعل, مفعول and فعل. We learn grammar using TPI. And what is TPI? Hear it, see it, think it, say it, show it, love it,
do it
together. Let's take revision of what we have learned in previous lessons. You know, Arabic words are of three types. What are they? Ism, fi'l, and harf. And sign of ism is al in the beginning, like al-muslimu, and un an in, or un in at the end, like muslimun, musliman, muslimin, muslimun, muslimin, muslimat. And fi'l is the one which shows us the action, and harf is anything which is not ism or not fi'l. فعل is made up of three letters like فعل فتح. فعل is of three types: ماضي, that which is done, مضارع, that which is not done yet, being done or will be done, and أمر, which is order or request. And let us now just repeat all these forms, ماضي, مضارع, and أمر, for the verb فعل, he did. Okay, so can you repeat after me? فعل فعلوا,
فعل فعلوا,
فعلت فعلت,
فعلت فعلت,
فعلتم فعلنا,
فعلتم فعلنا.
مضارع يفعل يفعلون,
يفعل يفعلون,
تفعل أفعل,
تفعل أفعل,
تفعلون نفعل,
تفعلون نفعل.
And then افعل افعلوا,
افعل افعلوا,
do, you all do. أمر النهي لا تفعل لا تفعلوا,
لا تفعل لا تفعلوا.
ما شاء الله. And in the last class for أمر النهي we have done four verbs like اضرب. اضرب means hit. Can you repeat after me? اضرب اضربوا,
اضرب اضربوا,
لا تضرب لا تضربوا,
لا تضرب لا تضربوا.
And similarly listen, اسمع اسمع, اسمعوا,
اسمع اسمعوا,
لا تسمع لا تسمعوا,
لا تسمع لا تسمعوا.
And اعلم, اعلم means know. Okay, repeat after me. اعلم اعلموا,
اعلم اعلموا,
لا تعلم لا تعلموا,
لا تعلم لا تعلموا.
And the last one was اعمل, do, from عمل. So اعمل اعملوا,
اعمل
اعملوا, لا تعمل
لا تعمل, لا تعمل لا تعمل.
That was about أمر and نهي. And we also have learned four styles of verbs, okay, which is فتح يفتح افتح. Okay, similarly next one is نصر ينصر انصر. And third one ضرب يضرب اضرب. And سمع يسمع اسمع. Alright. And also we have learned how to remember these forms, sentences like if you open the Quran, فتح, Allah will help you. نصر, otherwise you will be hit. ضرب, therefore listen. سمع. Now let's take today's lesson, in which we will take فعل, مفعول and فعل, and we have divided every lesson into small units for practice breaks. So let's take the first one, first unit, saying Alhamdulillah with a smiling face. So we will learn to make فعل, مفعول, فعل from the three letters فعل. Well, very simple. Just say فعل and it will be doer. فعل means doer, the one who does. Okay, and the TPI action for that is, you know, like you give someone something, so it's like this. فعل is the doer, and that it's like giver, the one who gives, the one who does will be the one who can give. So anyway, our sign for فعل is like the one who gives. Okay, فعل, doer, the one who does. مفعول is the one who is affected. Okay, it doesn't have to be on the right side, I'm just showing it to you for ease of view. So fa'il is doer, like that in front of you, not on this side. Okay, don't turn, just like this. Fa'il, the doer, and maf'ul is the one who is affected. So maf'ul is like a receiver, because he's receiving, affected. So one who gives charity is the one who does the work, and the one who receives charity is the one who is affected, okay, positively. Whatever, fa'il, doer, maf'ul, the one who is affected. And fi'l is to do, or act of doing. Can you translate? Fa'il,
doer,
maf'ul,
the one who is affected.
Fi'l,
to do.
Again, fa'il,
doer,
maf'ul, the one who is affected. Fi'l, to do. Now repeat after me in Arabic. The three of them together. Fa'il, maf'ul, fi'l.
Fa'il, maf'ul, fi'l.
Fi'l. Again, fa'il, maf'ul, fi'l.
Fa'il, maf'ul, fi'l.
Fi'l. Fa'il, maf'ul, fi'l.
Fa'il, maf'ul,
fi'l. MashaAllah. Allim. Alhamdulillah. Let's take the plurals now. You know already how to make the plural of Muslim, which is Muslimun, Muslimin. So plural of fa'il will be fa'ilun, fa'ilin. By the way, fa'il sign. Fa'il, fa'il, fa'il. So fa'ilun will be a little stretch like this. Okay, little stretch like this. Fa'ilun, fa'ilin. But that is only to show, otherwise it's not necessary. And plural of maf'ul, maf'ulun, maf'ulin. Maf'ul, maf'ul, maf'ul. So maf'ulun. Maf'ulun or maf'ulin, same sign for this case. Alright, so I'm asking you, hal anta fa'il? Are you doing, doer? And I mean, everyone is, mashallah, doing good deeds. So are you doing, quote unquote, understood good deeds? So you'll say, na'am, yes, ana fa'il. So anta will become ana here. Fa'il is not changing. You are fa'il, I am fa'il. So everyone is fa'il, so only anta will become ana. Hal antum fa'ilun? So you can say, na'am, yes, nahnu fa'ilun. Yes, we are doers. So can you answer me? Hal anta fa'il?
Na'am, ana fa'il.
Ana fa'il. Hal antum fa'ilun?
Na'am,
nahnu fa'ilun. So antum will become nahnu. Fa'ilun will stay as it is. Again, answer me. Hal anta fa'il?
نعم
أنا فاعل. هل أنتم فاعلون؟
نعم
نحن فاعلون. علم. الحمد لله. Now let us take the second verb, which is فتح. فتح, he opened. So you see, فعل becomes فاعل. So فتح will become فاتح for opener. Okay, فتح, he opened. فاتح, opener. Similarly, fa'ala, this is fa'il, maf'ul. So this is fatih, maftuh. Okay, maftuh, that which is open. The formula is same. So you start with mim, ma, and add u. So add waw, maftuh. Anyway, can you translate fatih, opener, maftuh, that which is opened, and fath is to open. Here it is not fith, like fi'il. It is fath. Now this, you know, action, this is a sign of fi'l, action. This action, the formula for making this fi'l or fath or ibadah, there are many formulas. So just take as it is, this one. But this formula is fixed. Fa'il, maf'ul, this formula is fixed. Fath can change. Fath, fi'l, ibadah, maghfirah. So the nouns will be, I mean, the verbal noun, the name of the action, can change. So can you translate please? Fatih, opener, maftuh, that which is opened. Fath, to open. Repeat after me in Arabic, three together. Fatih, maftuh, fath.
Fatih, maftuh, fath.
Fath. Again, fatih, maftuh, fath.
Fatih, maftuh, fath.
Fath. Fatih, مفتوح فتح
فاتح مفتوح فتح
فتح علم. الحمد لله. You may be opening the Quran or opening the door of masjid, so I will say هل أنت فاتح؟ Are you the opener? I will say نعم أنا فاتح. Yes, I am the opener. هل المسجد مفتوح؟ Now I'm using مفتوح also. Is the masjid open? هل المسجد مفتوح؟ نعم المسجد مفتوح. Okay. So can you answer me? هل أنت فاتح؟
نعم أنا فاتح.
هل المسجد مفتوح؟
نعم
المسجد مفتوح. Well, I don't think you have to show all this. Times you may be confused. أنت فاتح، أنا فاتح. So you understand what we mean. So you don't have to show too many signs because it's simple Arabic. Again, هل أنت فاتح؟
نعم
أنا فاتح. هل المسجد مفتوح؟
نعم المسجد مفتوح.
Yes, the masjid is open. علم. الحمد لله. Let's take the third one, which is جاعل, from جعل. Okay, جعل. جعل, he made. جاعل, the maker. مجعول, that which is made. And جعل, to make. Can you translate جاعل?
Maker.
مجعول, that which is made. جعل, to make. Again, جاعل,
maker.
مجعول,
that which is made.
جعل, to make. Repeat after me. جاعل مجعول جعل
جاعل مجعول جعل
again جاعل مجعول جعل
جاعل مجعول جعل
again جاعل مجعول جعل
جاعل مجعول جعل
جعل علم الحمد لله. Now let us take spoken Arabic. Assume that you are making something good, so I'm asking هل أنت جاعل. Are you maker? I would say نعم أنا جاعل. Yes, I am a maker. هل أنتم جاعلون? Are you makers? نعم نحن جاعلون. Yes, we are makers. Again, answer me. هل أنت جاعل?
نعم
أنا جاعل. هل أنتم جاعلون?
نعم
نحن جعلون. Very good. علم. Alhamdulillah, we have very small units, so don't worry about numbers here. Let's take next one. The last one in terms of practice. Nasir. It is from Nasara. Nasara, he helped. Nasir, the helper. Nasir, helper. Mansur, the one who is helped. And Nasr, to help. Again, Nasir, helper.
Helper.
Mansur, the one who is helped. Nasr, to help. Translate. Nasir,
helper.
Mansur,
the one who is helped.
Nasr, to help. Or the action of help. Help. Repeat after me in Arabic. Nasir, Mansur, Nasr.
Nasir, Mansur, Nasr.
Again. Nasir, Mansur, Nasr.
Nasir, Mansur, Nasr.
Nasir, Mansur, Nasr.
Nasir, Mansur, Nasr.
Alim. Alhamdulillah. Now let us take spoken Arabic. The real helper is Allah. He is Nasir. All of us are helped by Allah. We are Mansur. Or Mansurun. Plural will be Mansurun. But anyway, I am Mansur. Let's say singular. Hal. Huwa Nasir, I'm referring Huwa to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's up and above the heavens. So I will not use this sign. But you know the meanings. And Nasir, this is the sign, but these sentences are too simple, so I will not use signs for this sentence. Hal Huwa Nasir?
Naam Huwa Nasir.
Huwa Nasir. Hal Anta Mansur?
Naam
Ana Mansur. Yes, I am helped. The one who is helped. Again, هل هو ناصر?
نعم.
نعم.
هو ناصر.
هل أنت منصور?
نعم.
أنا منصور. علم. الحمد لله. Now let us take your homework. This is homework, so we'll do it very fast. خلق means he created. So خالق will be creator. مخلوق, the one who is created. And خلق, to create or creation. Repeat after me. خالق مخلوق خلق.
خالق مخلوق خلق.
Again. خالق مخلوق خلق.
خالق مخلوق خلق.
Again. خالق مخلوق خلق.
خالق مخلوق خلق.
And this is also homework. ذكر. ذكر means he remembered. ذاكر, the one who remembers. مذكور, the one who is remembered. ذكر, to remember. Okay, can you translate? ذاكر,
the one who remembers.
مذكور,
the one who is remembered.
And ذكر, to remember. Okay, repeat after me. ذاكر, مذكور, ذكر.
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 MashaAllah. Let's take the learning tip now. Inviting the brain to learn. How do you invite? Well, here is an example. Will you invite someone to a dinner with a tired, boring, low, spiritless voice? Never. You know, for example, some people, they do the exercises like this. Samya, Samya, Samya. So, will you invite someone to dinner like this? Come to dinner. And perhaps the one who is invited would rather starve rather than respond to such a, you know, useless invitation. So, how will you invite your brain to do the grammar practice and the translation? Not like a tired or bored person. Do all of these practices with love and enthusiasm, with enthusiasm. For example, you know, سَمِعَ سَمِعُ سَمِعْتَ سَمِعْتُ سَمِعْتُمْ سَمِعْنَا يَسْمَعُ يَسْمَعُونَ تَسْمَعُ أَسْمَعُ تَسْمَعُونَ نَسْمَعُ. There has to be passion there. You know, an enthusiasm should be there. Thanking Allah for giving this opportunity to learn the Quran. By the end of this lesson, 18th lesson, we have learned 222 words which occur in the Quran almost 40,469 times. Alhamdulillah. Don't forget the 7 types of homework. 2 on tilawa, 2 on study, listening to concise recording, talking about the course, reciting different surahs, and 2 du'as. Rabbi zidni ilma, and may Allah help us to learn the Quran in a Quran class. So try to form the Quran class. Don't forget that. And even if people drop, don't give up, don't be disappointed, pray for them. And don't forget to carry this vocabulary sheet always in your pocket. And the real way to learn is to teach. Download the PPTs and start teaching, or collect the people, play the videos, pause it every 5 minutes, practice what has been taught, and then continue. And you can do that. And teachers training is also available at understandquran.com. May Allah help us to recite, understand, ponder, implement, propagate, and memorize the Quran. Jazakumullah khair. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.